Hi, I'm Rafael Ruggieri, and this is Anatomy with the Doctor Dude, How the Body Works. Let's take this one organ at a time.
And today's organ is...
Esophagus!
Katie?
Yeah?
How does your food get from your mouth to your tummy?
Your esophagus, duh.
What's esophagus?
That's a great question. You know who we should ask? The Doctor Dude!
Little did the girls know that the Doctor Dude was listening to their conversation. Let's start in ancient Greece.
Where does the word esophagus come from?
It originates from the Greek word oesophagus, which comes from the root words oesen, meaning to carry, and phagein, meaning to eat. So literally, the word means to carry what you eat. And that is exactly what the esophagus does. It carries what you eat from your mouth to your stomach.
You look good in a dress.
It's not a dress, it's a toga.
Dress!
Toga! Whatever. Catch you later.
Where is the esophagus in the body?
Well, let's take a look using our body diagram. As you can see, the esophagus is a long tube extending between the mouth and the stomach. It is made up of different types of muscles. There are muscle fibers that are circular, going around the esophagus, and other fibers that are straight, going along the length of the esophagus. These muscles will flex in a rhythmic fashion so that they propel food from one end, by the mouth, to the other end, and into the stomach. Both at the top and the bottom, there are muscular mechanisms that create what we call sphincters, which will open and close as needed, and thus allow food to enter or leave the esophagus when it is supposed to, and not when it should not. These protect you from swallowing air while you are trying to breathe at the top, and from having acid reflux from the stomach at the bottom of the esophagus.
It burns!
Also, there are glands within the esophagus. A gland is a microscopically small factory that your body has to produce something liquidy. In the case of the esophagus, mucus is created, which is a slimy and slippery liquid, like phlegm, from your throat. It is expelled into the esophagus to keep the esophagus moist and to make it slippery so that the food will slide right down.
Now that you've explained it, can you show us how it works?
Sure. Every day starts with breakfast.
Yum! French toast, my favorite!
Let's take a bite.
Here comes the airplane! Open up!
This is your mouth.
Is that plaque on your teeth?
Nope, those are flowers.
And there's our French toast, which is making my mouth water.
That's our saliva, which your mouth produces in abundance when you eat. More spit, please. Spit, or saliva, is made up of water and mucus, and other chemicals that help break down food. The fork grinding up against the sides of the bowl is representing the grinding of the food that happens between your teeth. You can see here that as you grind the food up, it mixes with the saliva, making a nice mush that will easily slide down your esophagus without causing any harm. Yummy, yummy!
You can't make me eat it!
Open up, here comes the airplane! Down the hatch!
This is our makeshift esophagus, and my hand is representing the muscles of the esophagus squeezing in an organized fashion to propel the food downward toward the stomach. Let's watch that again.
In slow motion.
Very satisfying.
One more thing. Because of its rhythmic muscle contractions, called peristalsis, the esophagus works upside down too.
Well, we hope you enjoyed our presentation on the esophagus. Let's briefly recap what we learned today. Girls?
We learned the Greek origin of the word esophagus, and that it is a muscular tube that carries your food from your mouth to your stomach.
It has glands that produce mucus.
It has sphincters at the top and at the bottom that close and open as needed.
It works right side up and upside down.
This is just one of many videos that we hope to produce for your entertainment and education. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel for updates on new videos. Please like the video and share it. Thank you for tuning in. See you next time.